The monitor does not does the I'd like to give the floor to Alexander Lebedev. I met him 10 years ago. There is no need to introduce him to you, but we met at that point of time when the company knew Commonwealth, of which I am one of the co-managers. We were busy manufacturing civil aircraft, and Alexander was building up the system of leasing of Russian-made aircraft. And recently I heard that Alexander wants to sell the company Red Wings, which transports a lot of passengers, operating Russian aircraft. He wants to sell this company for the price of $1. And we do not manufacture aircraft. So now we see the deindustrialization of Russia. Indeed, Russia is leaving the market of civil aircraft. Alexander, you have the floor. Thank you. I will take the 8 minutes basically to questions based on the real experience which I have gained over the last 10 years. But now that you have touched the issue of aviation industry, I would like to make a few clarifications. What you read in the mass media is not true. I proposed for one ruble to transfer part of the interest to the Ilyushin Finance, where I'm also a shareholder. It is aviation leasing company, in order to share the responsibility for the Red Wings company. We believe that until the next week, our discussions with the government will be over. And if they will have a co-financier, then and I will lose the financial responsibility. In this case, the government will be busy for the production of the aviation industry. None is using the Russian aircraft. There is no point to manufacture. Another block is plays the roles of supervisory body. They are afraid that the catastrophe will happen. It's the reason that the reason for this aviation, this catastrophe with new Sukhoi was 204 is the second catastrophe and the operation of this new aircraft. Let us wait until the conclusion of the competent commission. If we come to terms, then the deadlock of the government, which is interested. And I do believe that the White House and Kremlin wants to manufacture, Russian aircraft, mid-range. I do not understand. We have built up the competence for the 6 years. We are able to operate regular, flights. And in terms of the various parameters, if we come to terms, then I would be better placed to understand what the government wants. But this is a very good question to ask. Why we are losing the aviation, my opposition aviation? And why Russian aviation carriers do not operate Russian aircraft? Well, they have already switched over to Boeing and Airbus. They mimic the pattern of dependence on the Western aviation company. Leasing payment in budget of any carrier is one of the key cost items along with the aviation carriers, and we pay for those two 200 aircraft, which will lease a couple of billion of US dollars to Western aviation leasing companies. We should change this system, and it was my pleasure to read in one one of the papers that in Russian railway company research was completed in terms of the long-term routes which are not profitable, and they say that want to discuss with the government to subsidize aviation cargo for certain length of distance. And Russian aircraft has any advantages in using this subsidy, then it will be possible to raise the rent of the company and to structure the portfolio of orders for the 205, Sukhoi 205 aircraft, which has been certified, would be possible. So those are the problems that we are facing, but let me remind you that the issues of regulation, the government as the arbiter and the players are very important for those 150 say, aircraft plants which manufacture various parts of this aircraft should be filled with orders. And now let me get back for a second to the name of our panel, the dependency on raw materials. I have gained certain experience in operating in the raw material industry, and I am a minority and majority shareholders in a number of oil companies. I still shareholder of Gazprom, I am surprised. Modernization is something which the raw material industry also needs badly. So if they are not something, this is not something which one area of activity rules out the other. So major industrial solutions should also be implemented in the raw material mining industry. In the Pechora province, for example, the oil with low length is not manufactured. All major oil companies do not even know how to. They do it in Canada and in USA. They believe that it is not profitable. They happy to drill for 2 kilometers, but they will have to switch over to new technologies. Either they will have to import new technologies to develop those new technologies of producing oil from low horizons. But quite often, big corporations do not develop the, sea shelters, and we all read, while should they not develop the oil in the sea shelf in Dagestan. There are case with the Dutch company, the Russian state is such that they did not allow the for the Danish company to produce oil in the sea shelf of seabed of Dagestan, because Gazprom believes that only they should be have the right to develop there. But that is denial of the ability for the foreign private capital to be present in the Russian company. Let me also discuss the government policy in the area of privatization and innovation. You will see that we, Michigan Bank was convinced to refinance Rosnana and Renault to manufacture solar panel, which was supposed to be built in 2010, that the cost of the solar panel as an end product due to the China scheme went down by the factor of 5. There is no profitability there. But if we do not fail, if we do not learn how to take good decisions at the government level, no state corporations will save us, and I think a lot of projects should be revised, which were implemented using the money of Rosnana corporations in the area of primary production of silicon and production of solar panels. I think that the cost were $1.5 billion, and when we understood that this project is no longer profitable, they were given as a burden to the Russian banks, and I do not believe that the Russian banks should be used as a dustbin for projects which cannot be implemented. And I will share with you my experience in the agriculture. Many people believe that this is a secondary, tertiary area in terms of the processing of agricultural products. Now, it's one of the most complicated technological processes. Well, you understand that there are two different things to manufacture potato or to manufacture potato chips. To manufacture such plants over becoming the bureaucratic barriers until the moment when the government becomes a just and profitable and a just regulator and leave the, say, provisions of owner. But let me tell you, without the parliament, the political system, without the independent media, free elections and parliament and independent judiciary, which would provide protect the rights of ownership, we'll never get the desired results, and also get stumble across what the Russian government is now trying to fight. I mean, corruption and the voluntary actions on behalf of many governmental departments. So it is only within the in the context of the fight between the political say institutions, which would compete among themselves, that we'll be able to arrive at a solution. I have asked more questions than have given answers. Thank you for your attention.